Hello and welcome back to Push the Talk, the series where I, Lewis, talk about particular topics in and around the gaming sphere to help keep you in the loop. And today we are going to be talking about Halo and the possible switch to Unreal Engine. But before we get into all of that, you guys know the drill. Like the video and subscribe if you want to see more content like this, and to obviously ding dong that notification bell if you don't want to miss out when we upload next. And with that said, let's get straight into it. Now we all know Halo, most of us console kids probably grew up playing it, but the Halo we play today is by no means the same one that we played as kids. Actually, it hasn't been the same since 2007 with the release of Halo 3, when Bungie left the rights with Microsoft and 343 Industries. Since then, the playerbase has been extremely critical on 343's take on the franchise, with most of us, yes me included, hoping that that will all change with Halo Infinite. And well, let's just say it didn't have the best launch. The game was delayed by a year, which obviously pissed off a lot of fans. Halo Infinite's beta was finally released a year later, and it was received fairly positively, even though it only had multiplayer. The Halo esports community felt refreshed when Halo Infinite's beta came out. Many said that it felt like Halo 5's movement mechanics with traditional Halo, which is... those are the two biggest differences. I don't know how you compare them, but I kind of get it. But when the game finally released, it was discovered that Forge and co-op campaign were nowhere to be found. 343 came out and said that the two were delayed, leaving players pretty much just twiddling their thumbs. And that was really it for a while at least. There was only multiplayer and campaign to play. At least until last month, nearly a year later. 343 finally came out with a blog post confirming the dates for both co-op campaign and Forge, along with the pretty big news that split-screen co-op campaign would be cancelled. The community was in uproar as many wanted to re-experience the nostalgia that came with split-screen. In case you're wondering, the co-op campaign and Forge beta will finally come to us on November 8th. And to further add fuel to the fire, it was announced that Bonnie Ross, the head of 343 Industries, was finally stepping down after 15 years with the studio. And even more changes could be coming to Halo's infrastructure, as 343 is reportedly dropping their Slipspace engine for Unreal Engine. To back this all up, it was reported that the lead engineer of 343's Slipspace engine, David Berger, had departed last month. In case you don't know, the Slipspace engine is the game engine which Halo Infinite currently runs on. 343 began secretly working on the engine shortly after the release of Halo 5. This all surfaced thanks to Jeremy Penta, a journalist who wrote on Sunday, "I can only confirm that many sources are saying this, and very clear that it's already been decided and Halo is for sure switching to Unreal." Now it's unclear as to whether or not the switch will apply to Halo Infinite itself. 343 has announced that they are committed to supporting Halo Infinite for the next decade, so a game engine change is very much in the cards, but this could foreshadow some bumps in the road that could definitely displease fans. There are little to no games that made the bold move of switching game engines post-release. The closest thing we have to this are games switching engines after they're announced. All of this does beg the question, why the change? Creating an engine from the ground up comes with extremely high cost and effort. That's why many opt for third-party solutions such as Unreal Engine or Unity. So to ditch the engine that was specifically made for the said game doesn't quite make too much sense. That's not even to mention how much of a programming nightmare this will be. While it is doable, you are essentially recreating all the code. Unfortunately, a lot of the code can't be translated between engines due to syntax and logic differences. Most of the art would be reusable, but that would mean that they would have to rewrite the shaders. That is a lot of work, and because of this, 343 Industries wouldn't be able to update the game in increments. They would have to spend a significant amount of time developing what is essentially a brand new game. But what this does mean is that when the update does come, it's going to be a big boy. Imagine you're opening your Steam and you're met with a 50 to 70 gigabyte update. Most of us are probably going to have to leave that boy downloading overnight. But a brand new engine brings a whole lot of new issues, meaning there will have to be another beta for this new version of Halo Infinite. 343 will probably create a public test server for players to test out the new engine, so that they can fix any new bugs that comes with the transition. But is the engine change necessary? Honestly, it's hard to say. From a gameplay perspective, I don't find much wrong with Infinite's gameplay. If it's the movement you're talking about, then you can treat Infinite like a traditional Halo. Or you can use the in-game mechanics, which makes it feel a little bit more like Halo 5. The gunplay is satisfying, although a lot harder from previous Halos, there's not really much need for a change either. And if it's cosmetics, then again, it doesn't really make too much sense. The overall aesthetic of the game is extremely reminiscent of Halo, with a hint of realistic shading. But other than that, the game itself looks pretty damn good. So the only possible thing that I can imagine is to get the game to run better. But in the past couple of months, I haven't heard many issues in regards to how the game runs. So with the information that we have right now, it's kind of hard to make sense of the situation. Of course, we the public don't know what goes on behind closed doors, and with the many changes going on with the game studio right now, this may have been something that Microsoft has wanted to do for a very long time now, but just haven't been able to due to 343's leadership. But I guess we'll just have to wait and see. And that's it for this week. If you guys have any topics that you want me to discuss, then feel free to leave a comment down below. And again, if you did enjoy the video, then make sure to leave a like, subscribe if you want to see more content like this, and to obviously ding dong that notification bell. Thank you all for watching. My name's been Lewis from Kakuchopurei, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Ciao for now.